That's sexy. 4K.
4K?
4 freaking K.
4K.
Yeah. Got video.
What did you like take her in the Ranger?
No. My mom's car. Look at this little guy. Hey.
I finally got my Duncan. It's 2:30 p.m. and I've been looking since 8 a.m.
Sword and pistol by my side.
He's like a gas stop number 3, I want to say. Done about 1,000 miles. I got lost a few times trying to find this gas station, so. I think it's about to rain. To be honest, I'm pushing the Ranger a little hard here. I think we're going up some mountain and it's way uphill, like 45 degrees, and you know, I had to put it in third gear to make it up. I was losing speed. So apparently I'm heading straight for severe thunderstorms. Whoever issued this severe thunderstorm warning, I think you might be right. Windy as hell, it's shaking my whole truck. And look at this side. Right in here. I got my compass if anything goes south, so I'll be all right. Yeah, no, they're definitely right about this severe thunderstorm thingamabob. As you can see, beautiful weather here in Tennessee. I found a slight issue where this is leaking, which means my truck is no longer waterproof.
Yeah, baby.
While sudden historic rains have added insult to injury in Mayfield, Kentucky.
The water is completely covering some roads in Paducah.
Overwhelmed with water that it actually collapsed. There's a
honestly, driving under a metal bridge in a gigantic thunderstorm. It's pretty scary. It's like a giant lightning rod. I'm right under it in a friggin' tin can of a truck. All right, good morning. It is day 2. It is 3:58 in the morning. I wanted to wake up before 4 a.m. because scheduled thunderstorm at 4 a.m. so probably before 4 I'll miss the storm, but looks like it's already raining. Awesome. 6 a.m. I just got into Kentucky and it is crazy outside. Huge thunderstorm. There's so much lightning. I want to see if I can get one on video. Oh yeah, there she is. Right now, I'm stopped under a bridge because I had to dry the inside of my car off because it is raining too much and my car's not really the best water sealed or something or other. Pretty sweet bridge here in Kentucky. So, weather's beautiful as always. I took a wrong turn. Holy shit.
Yeah, I'm really glad I get to see Kentucky. This is awesome. Wrong exit, and there is not a single person on this road. Flash flood warning. Do not attempt to travel unless you are fleeing a certain area. And this is the certain area. So, this is good. This is good. And I've already seen two cars that were completely flooded, like up to the windows.
Look at this. Look at this. What the hell?
Look at, that's not a lake. This is the road. Oh my God. What is this? This completely flooded. Look at this. Look at that. What the hell? It's in the Mississippi River right now. I really, really, oh my God, there's lightning right next to me. It's like following me around. So it's been like 4 hours in this storm. Just entered Missouri. My truck isn't even waterproof. It's leaking. It's leaking through the friggin' roof. Officially made it out of the storm. 4 hours of like torrential downpour. Still got about 7 hours till Wichita. So
ZipRecruiter.com/truecrime.
In the Savannah grasslands of Africa, I was very interested in exploring the area around the lake.
In the dark, was early in the morning, just before I rose to travel, up comes a band of red men, and like, there's Captain Farrell. I first produced me pistol, for she'd stolen away me rapier, but I couldn't shoot the water, so a prisoner I was taken, a sharing the
we're getting big.
What's up, dudes? Where's he going? See you later.
It was about a 10-hour, supposed to be a 10-hour drive, but it took around 12 hours, because that whole incident with the storm added like another 2 hours. Also, I took a wrong turn and went through Kentucky back roads while the flash flood was happening, which that was not good. Every 5 seconds, bam, 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 and I was kind of scared for my life, not gonna lie, but. And honestly, Kansas is pretty cool. They have like these little oil things that are pumping and twirling, and I think it's oil, I don't really know, but now I'm in this cabin, Airbnb, $30, and no toilet. So, don't know what I'm gonna do about the morning poop situation, but I guess I'll figure it out. I'm gonna have to stop somewhere, or just take a dump in these woods.
You might be wondering why I have pants, a sweatshirt, and boots on in 90 degree Kansas weather. Well, it's because I'm awesome, first of all. And second of all, because there's a slight mosquito and tick problem, apparently. Cheers. Modelo number two.
Thank you.
think it's time for a little day four update. Been on the road for about an hour and a half. It took me 90 miles north through something like North Kansas now. There's absolutely nothing. Luckily, the roads are really nice. It's either they're really nice or they're under construction. But no, there's literally nothing here. A few cars in the road and like a few giant concrete structures for farming. I don't really know what they are or what they do. It's a 411 mile stretch. It'll take about 5.5 hours. You know what it looks like is the home screen to the Windows, like Windows 7 home screen. It's like green hills. In Denver, I'm gonna stop at Micro Center on the way there because I've always wanted to go to one. And I'm gonna go see Brendan. So yeah. Woo. It starts raining.
Now his life is full of wonder, but his heart still knows some fear of a simple thing cannot comprehend.
Cheers.
While they try to tear the mountains down, bring in a couple more people, more stars.
Oh, the tail. The tail didn't go down.
All right, day four recap. Now I'm in Denver with my boy Brendan.
Hey there. Welcome to Colorado.
Colorado. Brown. Got a few beers, had a shot
with weird scorpion shot.
With a scorpion inside of it.
We'll see how that comes out.
it was better than expected. I had pickle juice, vodka or tequila, something around there, some sort of alcohol. Really good. And then we had a few Modelos and a few cores. Head to Utah.
Utah.
Day four, baby.
Go Cali. Roll Tide.
Another wrong turn, and that's the highway over there, and I'm on this road for some peculiar reason. But truck's still doing good, and you know, you go where she takes you. Shit is crazy, dog. Day four recap. I'm on my phone because camera died, but Airbnb I'm in, it's a little trailer. Well, technically, I was talking to the owner. He said it's called a sheep camp. And this is what the people from Utah used in the mountains when they were like herding sheep for the season. It's from like the 1940s. This is a real old one. It's got a lot of posters and cool little stuff here. It's on a farm actually, and the owner and his little kid, he's probably like 6 or 7. There's a few horses, like 10 horses, like 10 little goats, a bunch of chickens, and like 5 of these super chill dogs.
this little kid had a bow and arrow that he was showing me. Yeah, it's I didn't expect much at first. I was like, this is not like the most spacious area, but there's a bathroom over there, which is really nice, because the other cabin didn't have a bathroom. I turned out to really, really like this place, you know. Sleeping, it's a part of Utah's history. Probably almost 100 years old. Use this thing to herd sheep and do all the sheep thing, do the wool and all that. They're super friendly. Even like the people at Dunkin' were so, so nice. They're like, oh, you want some hash browns with that? I'll give it to you for free. I was like, okay. Yeah, so free hash browns. Not really meant for people over 6 foot, I want to say. That'll be a little issue tonight. Day six to Reno tomorrow. So, yeah. Catch you later. Salt Lake. Kind of looks like Florida, like all the little lakes and like swampy. I thought next to me was water, but it's actually like friggin' sand or like salt. I think it might be like the salt things. I was gonna do just Torino, but kind of got this hotel. I didn't look at the reviews before, and it has 1-star review saying that they're pretty much just taking the deposit, not giving it back, and then using your credit card like to buy pizza and all that. This is probably the most treacherous stretch of the trip, because it's gonna be hot as hell in Nevada. It's gonna be in the middle of nowhere, so if I break down, that'll be really unlucky. But truck's still running pretty good. It took a little while to start up this morning, but so far so good. It's a lot of uphill, a lot of downhill. The uphill kind of sucks because I have to put into like fourth or third gear and go like 45 miles per hour. But I was just I'm in the middle of Nevada. Nothing really around here. I was at a Dunkin' Donuts that had a casino that was built in. Inside the Dunkin' Donuts. I was like, what the hell? So, of course, I had to play one. Slot machine. I put in a dollar and I made 25 cents. Well, no, technically I lost 75 cents, but, you know, take a win where you can. So. Challenge of today is gonna be getting up the mountain to where I live. That's gonna be the hard part. It's like a 25 degree incline or something. Pretty sure I've done a few inclines like up Salt Lake, and it was I think max like 10. So let's hope the old ranger can get us up that mountain. Day six, chick. Heading to the Sierra Nevada mountains. This shit is gnarly. Sierra Nevada mountains, and it's like super sketchy. Hey! Oh, I'm in California. Let's go. Final stop. She made it. She made it. I'm in friggin' California. Woo! See if she can hold out. An hour and a half. She's making a little bit of noise, but Yeah, that just means you gotta turn the music up.
It's like people from California like traffic. It's like what they do for fun. It really makes no sense. Either that or they're just really freaking mad at driving.
We pretty much see our Teslas. And that just sparked up the idea that a Tesla could never do what I'm about to accomplish with as much style and as much swag. Like look how freaking ugly this thing is. Imagine this thing trying to go cross country. You know, it can never do it. And it's ugly, so. And my Ford Ranger is way, way, way more classy. So, minutes away and she's starting to overheat a little bit. I think I can make it though, it's not too bad. I think all uphill, really starting to overheat now. A little bit of smoke is coming out of the engine. Really struggling up this hill. So I don't know if I'm gonna make it.
Quarter of a mile, there left onto Hutchinson Road.
This is bad. I don't think I'm gonna make it.